Next up, we have Dr. Susan Payson. She's an ER and urgent care physician from Lima, and she's a patient safety advocate, passionate supporter of thyroids. So I think we need this.
Actually, I'm from Cincinnati area now. I've been in patient care through medical school for, started in 91, so I've been involved with patients for a long, long time. I have done any research, I don't write papers, I just see patients. And I have seen the injuries, vaccine injuries, I've seen vaccine reactions. I know that in the ER or in urgent care, these people are not my patients, they just come to me for emergency type things. I know that most of these things don't get reported because they come to us, not certainly emergently, but because they're looking for help, that the regular physician has this blind eye that the vaccine could have caused something concerning. I have to say that it is frustrating that even we, people like me and you, we're all on the same page here. Who do we send these patients to then to get help? I think that there's probably few physicians that really specialize in this that we know about, at least in our area. And it's confusing for the family, and it's confusing for us about health. I have seen in all these years a steady nosedive decline, not just in reactions, I'm off track of that, but decline in the health of children in general. 20 years ago, I could pick up a chart for a kid, and I usually would never see chronic diseases on their list, chronic medications they're on. And now it's like the norm. Not all of them, maybe not even the majority, but it's not weird to pick it up and have a kid on 5 medicines, 3 different diagnoses, and to walk in. And 20 years ago, we would have said, oh, I think you need a specialist, you need somebody higher level. But now, you know, we're all kind of used to it, so we're comfortable treating them. Chicken pox, it's funny that you talk about that. Shingles, 20 years ago, somebody who's healthy, 20 or 30 years old, comes up with shingles. We were having talks about, this means you're immunodeficient, we may need to do an HIV test. Now, I'm handing out a cycle here, that's a month to the same type of people. And I think it's because we're reducing those chickenpox, reducing those re-exposures that you need. Kids, little kids, school kids, I'm seeing a variation of shingles in them. It's not quite the same symptom complex, but it is a shingles rash. I think when you start messing around with nature, messing around, not the technical term, but you start doing that, you have other things that happen that you know. I don't know where that's going to end. Chicken pox is still relatively new. We don't know what's going to happen. Lots of companies as far as reaction there. Informed consent. I can tell you that we physicians and all the other people who administer vaccines, whether it's nurses, nurse practitioners, pharmacists, we do a poor job discussing risks of vaccines, even with adults, with the tetanus. We hand tetanus out like water in the ER, you know, lacerations and burns and all that stuff. And rarely do we really ever talk about the risks. And which one of us would really know all the risks to tell you? And on the other side, what are the real benefits? We assume things in the culture we hold on to that it's good, but we can't really put a finger on what is it. What are the benefits? Why are we doing this? If it's true that most of these childhood diseases declined before vaccines were introduced, and they haven't changed a whole lot since they've been on the schedule available, then what is the real benefit? Is it riskier to get the disease, or is it riskier to get the vaccine? And I don't think anybody really knows. So we all have our suspicions. But the real data, I haven't seen it. So can I really, in conscience, recommend to a parent or an adult who needs vaccine that the risks, the benefits outweigh the risks for this? I can't really, in conscience, say that. I don't personally know that. But yet, we're still doing it. The vaccine injuries, the vaccine reactions, if this was any other area of medicine, the product, device, whatever would be off the market. We have so many injuries, so many documented ones that are documented, even ones that aren't reported. Once they're documented, that's enough to pull this. this stuff and say, we need objective testing to really determine if this is safe or if it even works the way that we want it to. I'm a big advocate of patients' rights, parents' rights. If I tell you you need something, I give you the risk benefits, and you choose not to do it, that's fine. Taking away the philosophical exemption to some, not in this room, but elsewhere, you can tell other people you go home and talk to. People will say, well, we still have the other two. No big deal. We'll just say it's the other two. The thing is once you get rid of one, it's real easy to get rid of the next one. And before